All right, as you guys can see here, I've been working pretty hard at this new conspiracy, proving that the Earth is actually flat.
Cool.
What's up, everyone? It's Vince here, and I am going to start doing a few videos where I kind of react to or, you know, check out these certain videos that I want to share with you all that we'll see how it goes. This video is proving the Earth is flat, and I'm watching it on the phone because it's easier for me right now. And I'm going to play this. You can find this video that I'm looking at, and you can leave your feedback as well in the comments. You can comment on the blog, but the link is for this video is in the description box. It'll take you to the blog where you can see this video. It's by Ryan Higa, or Niga Higa. That's his YouTube name on YouTube, of course, obviously. I'm going to play the video. Once again, the video is in the description box. I'm going to play it in 1, 3, 2, 1.
RHBC House Wednesday, 11 a.m.
Why did you... What is that supposed to be?
Oh, the guy is always been...
Here we are on, like, the day
we got
time.
Some
isn't it Saturday?
Funny video.
Night.
Plus, that's not even our house.
Well, that's not important. What is important, and the reason why I called you guys over, I think I finally made a breakthrough in the new case.
People actually
God,
believe.
We're doing another one of these. I should have known better.
What?
Well, we're sitting on the couch. You're standing.
What are you talking about?
First thing you're gonna do is pull a lever or press some secret button and unveil your super secret lab. Then we're gonna have to listen to your conspiracy theories for hours.
Dude, what are you talking about? I was just talking about a breakthrough on this case.
Wait. Is that my suitcase?
Oh yeah, I forgot to tell you at the bar.
I'm just moving on.
Did you drill a hole in my suitcase? Why would you do that?
I just told you for the pun.
Yeah, because the hole is like the breakthrough and your case is like,
I
you know.
I get it, Sean.
Oh, and also I needed it to gain access to my secret lab so that we can start the next crazy conspiracy theory.
Where's your secret lab?
Oh, that's in the other room.
Then why did you have to drill a hole in my case? What was all that for?
To open it?
Oh my goodness.
Oh, there it is. Now we can get into the secret lab.
1 minute later in the other room.
Alright, as you guys can see here, I've been working pretty hard at this new conspiracy, proving that the Earth is actually flat.
Cool.
Where did that coat come from?
What?
It doesn't matter. Are you serious? Are you doing all this because of the Kyrie Irving thing?
Wait, who?
You know, Kyrie Irving, the famous basketball player that came out and said that he also believes the Earth is flat. It's ridiculous.
See, I thought it was ridiculous too, until I did a little bit of research and found that there's actually a lot of people that believe this.
Yeah, and they're ridiculous
and
too.
And I am one of them now.
You gotta be kidding me.
This is a real thing, okay? People actually believe that the Earth is flat. They're called flat earthers. And what they believe is that the government
anything
is
to call
people
with
the Earth is round
ER.
Time you're a little kid.
Okay, how do you explain actual satellite photos of Earth?
Photoshop? Editing?
Okay, well, what about people who've actually traveled the entire globe?
Just going in circles, not around the whole thing.
I mean, I'm not gonna lie, this one is
going
kind of
circles.
Hard to believe.
Exactly. Why would the government want to lie about the shape of the Earth?
See, that's exactly it. They're hiding the truth from us. A truth so mind-blowing that if people found out, the whole world would come to an end. And I am this close to figuring it out.
What are you doing?
I don't know, it's cool, right?
Got it from Spencer's.
I love Spencer's.
All right.
That's
let's
an
go
old
back
store.
To the very beginning, shall we? You see, in the beginning, everybody thought that the Earth was flat. But who were the first people to actually suggest that the Earth was round? Ancient Greek philosophers. And these philosophers have discovered a ton of things that we live by, but why don't we ever question them? They're ancient. For example, ancient Greek philosophers are the same people who have discovered constellations. You know, the idea of connecting stars to make pictures like the Big Dipper or zodiac signs.
I'm a Leo.
I'm uninterested.
But if you weren't taught about this as a kid and you were just to look at these pictures, it looks nothing like what they claim it to be. I mean, this looks like a child connect the dot homework from art class, which, by the way, he or she should probably get an M for. This looks nothing like a fish.
Sorry, I'll work on that.
Look, I agree. Constellations don't always look like what they're supposed to be, but what does that have to do with anything? We're talking about planets, not stars.
That's exactly it. What if it's both? See, our solar system is made up of one gigantic star and a bunch of planets orbiting around it.
Okay.
What if each of these planets are actually just points in one big constellation? You see, there's always been rumors and questions by people, including scientists, that believe that if at any point all the planets align, the world will come to an end. That's the constellation they're trying to hide from us. I call it Smovemjasun.
What?
Sun, Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune. That's the new zodiac sign, a modern day human.
How is that supposed to be a human being? It's a straight line.
Looks like somebody passed art class, right?
Yeah, I failed. What does this have to do with proving that the Earth is flat at all?
All right, let me point out the obvious. What are the two most vital things that humans need to survive?
I don't know, your brain?
Yep, and?
Your heart?
Exactly, your brain and your heart are the two most important things you need to live. Just like the two most important things that humans need to live in our solar system is the Earth and the Sun, located exactly where they should be in our constellation. The Sun powers everything in our solar system, just like our brain does, and yet we can't survive without the Earth, which is literally an anagram for heart if you just move the H to the front.
Okay, but what about the others? How the hell does Mercury represent a face?
Actually, it represents your mouth.
What?
The sun is the head, and as we all know, the sun gives off an incredible amount of heat. And when your head is feeling extremely hot, what does that mean?
You're sick?
Precisely, and when you're sick, you go and get a thermometer and put it where? In your mouth.
Thermometers are made of mercury.
Exactly. But remember, this constellation wasn't created today. It was created a very long time ago. And back in the day, you didn't just stick a thermometer in your mouth to check your temperature.
Really? Where else would you stick it in?
In Uranus! It couldn't be more obvious. Uranus is literally Sun's anus, which means that if Mercury is the mouth and Uranus is the anus, then we can figure out everything in between by looking at a regular human body. What is below the mouth but above the heart? Your throat or your neck. That's Venus. And since Saturn is right above Uranus, that must be your hips or your butt. Which would explain why it has that big hula hoop around its body, right? We go back up to Mars, which, again, is just another anagram for arm. It's self-explanatory. And Neptune is just basically everything below your anus, so it has to be your legs. As for Jupiter, I'm not quite sure. I mean, obviously, it's the stomach because it's between the heart and the hip area, but since Jupiter's the biggest of them all, there's a little more to it. It's not just a normal stomach. They're saying that it's a huge stomach.
What?
A huge stomach, meaning that Svevemjasun has something to do with the process of eating.
Really?
I mean, why else would they make the stomach that big? And when you really look at it, it does just look like a digestive tract.
Alright, so what about Pluto then? Pluto used to be considered a planet, but now it isn't. So what is that, like his toe or something, and then somehow it just disappeared?
Wait a second. It did disappear. Pluto wasn't actually attached to the body, but it represents the most human-like characteristic that leads us to our next step.
What are you talking about?
Yeah, I'm not too sure either.
Pluto is a fart! It went into Mercury, down to Venus, passing Earth and Mars, digesting Jupiter, preparing for takeoff in Saturn, and boom, right
wow,
out of Venus,
science.
Neptune off of the space. What? Disappearing.
Do you really expect anyone to believe this?
I believe it.
I mean, there's literally a picture right in front of you. Don't you see it?
It's a line.
Well, like I said earlier, did you get an F in art class?
No.
Well, then you don't have the eye of a Greek philosopher, so you can't see it. Probably just like how you didn't see that having an F in art literally spells out fart.
It does say fart.
I can't believe you're resorting to fart jokes.
This isn't a joke. What don't you understand?
Oh, I understand a lot of things, like facts and science.
Okay. You want facts and science? I'll prove it to you. You already know that a fart is simply gas that comes from Uranus. Uranus has 27 moons, the third most in our solar system. Why else do you think that when you expose your butt to someone, it's called mooning them?
See, you did it right there. Why are you talking about Uranus when it has the third most moons? Why don't you talk about Jupiter or Saturn?
Glad you asked. There's a reason why Uranus is ranked number 3 for the most moons. It all comes back to the biggest and gaseous thing in our solar system. The sun. You see, the sun is literally a gigantic ball of burning gas made up of mostly hydrogen, helium, and a bunch of other random elements such as carbon, nitrogen,
why
and
is he so in
there? As you get the number of each of these elements, you end up with 24. 3 short of the number of moons that Uranus has. And what was Uranus ranked on the list of planets with the most moons? That's right. 3. Bringing us to 27, the exact number of moons that Uranus has. So we know that Uranus is connected to the sun. But that's not the only one. You see, if we write all the planets backwards, there's only 2 planets that are connected to the sun. Uranus, as we already know, and one more, Venus. But why Venus out of all the planets? Why not Mars? We all know the saying, men are from Mars and women are from Venus, because Mars, or men, have always been their way to distract us from the truth, which lies with women, or more specifically, Venus. Think about it, why is the sun called the sun and not the daughter?
Yeah.
Why do we call the beginning of the week Sunday?
Well, why is it called son of a bitch but not daughter of a bitch? You can't be saying that on this channel. This is a family channel.
Well, why not? They say it on TV all the time.
Yeah, but they don't say it on, like, Dora the Explorer.
Son of a bitch.
Wait, are we allowed to say this now?
You see, bitch, by definition, actually means female dog.
Actually, no, I was thinking about
it. Yes, you did, because if not, we'll have to cut this part out. But males are just called dogs, so doesn't that make you wonder why you would even call a female dog a bitch?
No.
Exactly, it's very intriguing. You've heard of alpha male before, right? You know, the one that leads the pack?
Yeah. betas, the ones that follow. What about it?
Well, that's just like everything else in our world. Betas gravitate towards alphas. Not just with dogs or with humans, but our planets. The moon orbits the Earth and the Earth orbits the sun. It's all about alpha and beta, A and B.
But before you go on, please, can we at least take the sign down? It's a little offensive.
What, the a bitch sign?
Can you not?
No, no, it's not a bitch, remember? Because the A is alpha and the B is beta, so the B gravitates towards the A, making an itch. There's your proof.
What?
Abs are obviously referring to your stomach, and an itch is just discomfort, so it's stomach discomfort.
Okay.
But remember, there's a reason why they're distinguishing between men and women, which is the last step to proving my theory.
Thank God. Get this over with.
I can't wait.
Stomach discomfort, specifically for a woman, and only a woman, can only mean one thing. Pregnancy. The creation of life. However, because men can get pregnant, the only thing that stomach discomfort for men could possibly mean is something we already know. It's a fart! Farts are the babies of men! Women don't fart, right?
Not that I know.
Again, for the millionth time, how does a fart prove that the Earth is flat?
Look, it's simple. Giving birth is the creation of life to a human being. But a fart is much, much bigger than that. Flat Earthers were right all along. The Earth is flat, but that's not the only thing. The sun, all the other planets, everything in our entire solar system, the entire universe, it's all flat. Because it's all flat.
Oh my goodness.
Can you stop doing that?
What?
I'm not letting it end like this. You're not getting away with this one.
Getting away with it? I just proved it. The Earth is flat. It's flatulence.
Flatulence means farting. Don't worry. I had to look it up too on Google.
I get it, Sean.
Then what are you confused about? It all adds up. The Big Bang? What is the fart made of? Gas. Just like the sun.
Yeah, but see, that's the sun. And we're talking about the Earth, and the Earth isn't made of gas. It's a solid, which negates all of your logic, and props to you for doing all of this, but that does not prove that the Earth is flat.
That is true. I guess that means the Earth isn't a fart.
Thank you.
Because it's a solid fart.
A solid fart? What does that mean?
The Earth is shit.
Well then. I was not expecting him, him to talk about it like that. You know, he's a YouTube comedian or do skits anyway. But, you know, he always been, a lot of the videos that he and, I guess his name is Sean. Over the years, they always been making some funny videos. I remember their ninja videos that they used to do before the one guy, Sean, had, I guess he stopped or slowed down. I think the first time I heard somebody trying to bring up the possibility of the Earth being flat, I think it was some rapper named B.O.B. or Bob. I think somebody was pointing out, somebody who looks into a lot of conspiracy type of stuff, they found his tweets, and you know, he brought that up. Then somewhere down the line, Tila Tequila started bringing it up. So then it's like all these different beliefs, no matter what area it is, it makes you wonder. And then it's like, you know, you go searching for proof to see, you know, doing further research for yourself. But then there are certain things that, you know, become obvious, you know, common sense, you know. I've seen one video. There was like, I don't know if it was a rocket or what it was, where somebody they attached a camera to a rocket or something that went out to, you know, outer space. And it did stop when it, you know, was shot up to out in orbit, and it stopped right on a, you know, right on a dime, pretty much. Like it hit a ceiling. But most things, when you throw them up, you know, they kind of have a, you know, slow. But this one, they did have a, sounded like it hit. So I wish I could find that video just to, you know, just to show you guys. Then there's the people that they bring up the I think it's like the Hebrew map of the atmosphere, the whole thing about showing it's like a flat thing, and then it's got kind of like a aquarium. is what they're trying to say that we're in. So, I don't know. It's some crazy stuff. But then, you know, there's some things that's obvious. Like, one of them is, you know, when you, what happens if it's flat and you're going straight, not in water. Yeah, if, even if you were going across water, you know, if they're saying that it's flat, they're saying that you would fall off the edge, right? And that's how a lot of the what do you call them? The old, people from 10,000 BC or whatever, you know, long time ago, they used to actually believe these types of things. But anybody who has flown in an airplane, you know, you pretty much can tell that, you know, I don't know. What are your thoughts? Leave your comments. Tell me what you think of this whole flat earth thing. Do you believe it? I mean, you know, it's just crazy talk. You know, there's so many. Then again, you know, there's so much that has been suppressed, you know, information, and there's a whole idea that human beings, we are like, our intelligence has been so diminished to a real low level by some ancient something that manipulated our DNA, I don't know, eons ago or whatever. And we're actually way more intelligent than, I mean, we should be way like 30 times more intelligent, or some exaggeration, way more intelligent than we are on this, you know, like George Carlin said, we are semi-civilized beasts with baseball caps and automatic weapons. And listening to David Icke and, I don't know, Kratom Mutwa, they all talked about how we are, you know, going back to Atlantis. You know, even if that's, you know, that's kind of some of the things that I used to look into furthermore when I was more. I was always been curious about the alternative. Whatever the alternative was, I've always been curious. You know, there's, and anybody who's like that, you know, you're just so against the norm. So I'm going to stop this video. Subscribe. We're going to check out some other videos. Of course, I don't know if you have seen the video, but this video that we just checked out is in the description box. Once again, I'm gonna click this video off, subscribe, and we will meet up again in another video. Hey guys, it's me back again. I don't want to leave without letting you all know of an opportunity that allows people, if you want to check out what we're doing to build up a internet business, everything is in this system. Everything that you need for building an online business, all the tools, all the training, all of the mindset, even for content creation, all the different things for automation, and there's so much to make building a business online easier for you, as well as I mentioned the blog. If you're someone who is looking, if you have a small business, or you have your big business, or you know someone that is looking for a blog, the links are in the description box as well. Check those out. Thanks for sticking around. Thanks for sticking around, and I will meet up again in another video.